Church. I'm so excited you were able to join us today. I'm Miss Emily, and we're going to begin in prayer. So repeat after me. Dear Jesus, thank you for this wonderful day that you've given us. Thank you for allowing us to come to church online so we can learn more about you and we can spread the news to others. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Now let's get ready to worship Jesus.
Good to be reminded of who God says we are when we believe that the Lord Jesus Christ is our Savior. You know, God says that we are chosen, that we are not forsaken, that we are His children. So let's receive that today with open hearts as we sing this out together.
But He brought me in, oh, His love for me. Oh, His love for me. Who the Son sets free, oh, is free indeed. I'm a child of God.
Abuelita, abre la puerta, open the door, please. was in there in the little storage room and I found this. It's this. What is this circle? What do you do with this?
I remember that time. I'll show you.
The story of Easter. Jesus' sacrifice. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
The Jewish leaders and teachers did not like what Jesus was doing or how he claimed to be the Son of God. And so they made a plan to arrest him to get rid of him once and for all. Judas, one of Jesus' disciples, agreed to betray Jesus.
Come in.
And give him over to the religious leaders for some money. Jesus was in a garden praying, and Judas showed the man who Jesus was. Jesus was arrested and taken to the rulers of the land so that they could decide what to do with him. Jesus was presented before the high council, and they asked him if he was the Messiah, the Savior of the Jews. They asked him if he was claiming to be the Son of God. You say that I am. And the council was furious, and they shouted that Jesus was guilty and he deserves to die. So they took Jesus before the Roman ruler Pilate, and he heard the case against Jesus. Pilate didn't think that Jesus had done anything wrong.
Seemed okay to me.
They found him to be innocent, so Pilate said that he would punish Jesus and then release him.
What?
But the crowd kept screaming louder and louder, "Crucify him! We want him dead!" And because of the pressure of the crowd, Pilate turned Jesus over to the Roman soldiers to be crucified. Jesus was hurt and spit on. His clothes were torn and taken from him, and a crown made out of thorns was put on his head. He was beaten so badly that he could barely stand on his own. And then he was forced to carry his cross so far up a mountain that he needed help because he could not do it on his own. Once Jesus made it to the place where he would be crucified, called the Skull, the soldiers around him nailed him to the cross and waited for him to die. While Jesus was hanging on the cross, many people shouted to him, "If you really are the Son of God, save yourself from the cross." But Jesus knew he had to die to forgive his people for their sins. At noon, darkness fell across the whole land. 3 hours later, Jesus took his last breath and finally died. At that very moment, the curtain in the temple that separated the priests from God's holy place tore in two. A soldier watching the whole thing said, "This man truly was the Son of God." Then a righteous man named Joseph came and placed Jesus' body in a tomb. 3 days passed, and it seemed that there was no hope. But very early on Sunday morning, the woman who cared for Jesus went to go visit his body and found that his tomb was empty and that he was no longer there. "Don't be afraid," said an angel. "He is not here. He is risen." At this, the woman remembered that Jesus had told them that he would rise again on the third day.
Woo-hoo!
And ran to go tell the disciples what they had seen and heard.
Huh? Hey-o!
Ah!
And then for the next 40 days, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others and showed them that he was alive and well. He taught them that what he did was the only way that they could be forgiven and be with God forever. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life.
Jesus is the best and his love is like, whoa. Died for my sins and rose again like, whoa. Rolled back the rock and the guards were like, whoa. God's not dead, he's alive like.
You would not believe your eyes. You would not believe your eyes. You would not believe your eyes.
Julie, more like... Hey Jesus, heard you got that crucifixion. 3 days later, you resurrected. Thanks for dying for our sins.
Why did Jesus have to die? You know, that's a question we've all asked ourselves at one point. And I want to explain to you in a way that might make sense. With the visual. You see, my friend Jesus here came to take the sin that you have done or will ever do. And here, I mean, you look good. You look so nice, clean, refreshing, just the way God intended you to be. But we've all done stuff we're not very proud of. Maybe you've lied to your parents, you've cheated on a test, you've talked back to your teachers, and that's where sin gets involved. You begin allowing sin to come into your life and dirty you. God saw this, and he thought to himself, this is not how I intended it to be. So because God loved us so much, he sent his one and only Son, Jesus. Jesus was perfect. He came and lived a life with no sin. The question was, what would happen if Jesus took the sin of the whole world and put it in himself? And Jesus did just that.
He is worth following every single day, every single moment. I'll surrender to him again and again and again because he saved my life. And I didn't do anything to deserve it. And I don't need to do anything to keep earning this. I don't need to prove to him that I was worth dying for. Isn't that good news?
Yes, it was cool, but did you get the message from it? The message was that God sent his only son, Jesus, to die on the cross for you and to have a relationship with you.
What's a relationship?
A relationship is like what me and you have. We know each other, we spend time with each other, and in order to have a relationship with Jesus, we have to ask him into our heart.
But how do you do that?
By saying the Lord's Prayer. So say this with me.
We've been talking about how to make our life his story. And the first step in doing that is by making Jesus the Lord of your life. When you choose to give your life to Jesus, you become a part of God's family.
If you've never done that before, I want to give you a chance right now. Simply say this prayer out loud after me. Believe what you say with all your heart, and you will become a part of God's family. Say this after me. Dear God, I believe you sent Jesus to die for me. And I believe you raised him from the dead. Jesus, I make you my Lord. You are number one in my life. Amen. Great job. You are now a part of God's family.
If you're asking the question, what do I do now? There are two things that you need to do.
First, you need to tell somebody. If you know someone that loves Jesus, tell them. They love to celebrate with you.
Second, ask your parents to take you to church. One of the best ways for you to know Jesus is by learning about him at church.
If you still want to learn more, you can go to kidsonthemove.com/followjesus.
We'll see you next time.
See ya.
Hey, check me out real quick. This message is so good. Let it touch your heart. Jesus didn't care how many times you messed up. He died for you anyways. Jesus didn't care if you were the only person on earth. He would have died just for you. Because true love isn't about keeping score. It's about losing count. Jesus died for you because your life counted to
him. Flying my white flag, my white flag.
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Everybody out there makes their See you.